Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we are going to play with a 260. I have one replay for you, which was the best battle so far with a 260. And the games went quite bad with this vehicle. I'm not going to lie for you. The first 10 battles, I had such a big pain playing with this tank, and I still do in a way. But my motivation, my spirit is a bit higher than it was before. Let's say like that, comparing the 260. When I started everything, because I hated this vehicle, and how do I play with this tank now? So, the plan for today's video. We are going to start everything with a replay. I will explain everything what I was doing, and that was perfect battle in my eyes. And then we are going to play extra one or two games with a 260, and we'll see what I can craft live for you right now, okay? So without further ado, let's start our journey, fellas. And what do we have right here? We have the Maherm line, or however you are calling it, Maneherm line, whatever. Doesn't matter, right? The ice map, right? This is the best battle so far with a 260, and I'm slowly but surely getting the grip on this tank, right? So the first things first, what do we have right here? We have a flat tier 10 matchmaking, we have two enemy clickers, well, we have four Jeffs overall, two of them is enemy Jeffs. And what am I thinking? This tank don't have very good gun depression, so I am not thinking about going into the heavy line. Instead of doing that, I am thinking about the different strategy. You might wonder what is happening in my head. This is exactly what is happening in my head. So I am making a hardcore pressure towards the Charlie line, or 1-2-3 line. I'm not going to stop on the corner. I'm going to go for super duper hyper turbo hardcore pressure. That's what I want to do, fellas. So we are raising the gun, and I see we have 5 forces over there. And you know what? There is no point for us to stop, because if we will stop over there, Artav is going to fap on us for 3 days, 3 nights, and I don't want to see this kind of stuff happening. T62A is getting spotted. I'm yelling Russia, and obviously Russia is treating us good as intended. Now we are wiggling our upper plate, lower plate as much as we can. We are wiggling our nose, right? Good. Now we are in very good position. STB1 is pretty much the tank which can play perfectly hold down, and we are trying to craft the angle right here against the Mr. Progetto and against the T62A. And I don't want to give them time to relax or to enjoy themselves or to think. No, we are making hardcore pressure, obviously while playing hold down as much as we can right here, which is very, very good thing. Meanwhile, the T62A was thinking about escaping, but our Progetto is saying, look at me, pussies, we should go super aggressively. Meanwhile, Arta is punishing us over there, and I am missing the shot, but it's completely fine. Anyways, you think we are going to stop? No, we are not. I am immediately thinking what is going to be my action next. My action next is obviously going to be to hit this Leo, which is trying to escape. Kaboom, 400 in the ass. I'm trying to search for a shot for a Ruski light, but I can't do that because there is a massive stone. Now we are going to use the elevator to relocate a bit. Klurkst. Elevator worked just fine. As you can see, it wasn't that big of a jump. It was like 10 meters or so. I don't know actually how big the jump was, but it doesn't matter. Anyways, and now we are making a shortcut, and we are playing in the Delta 8, Delta 7 position. Why so? Because we want to find the, if someone is playing on the Echo 9 corner, we can punish them. Plus, on top of that, we can spot Jeffs. So what we are doing, we are going in front, and Jeff is getting spotted, and I am saying for a game, please RNG, let me hit this pixel shot, or another Arta is getting spotted. Good, thank you so much, RNG. That's very, very, very kind of you. And now, As you can see, I'm not making a hardcore pressure for the enemies, because I simply think it's not worth it, because I might get killed if Fosh B or Bobject is going to turn around. It's just going to be no bueno for us. So instead of making hardcore pressure, as Progetto does, I am relocating over there, and at least I'm going to have some kind of cooldown for myself. Believe me, it's very, very important. So right here, fellas, as you can see, Jack Pizda is trying to shoot our EBR, and obviously he hit the Ferrari, but Ferrari is not complaining because he made a hardcore pressure himself. By the way, that was a very unfortunate miss for us, considering we had a perfect tracking shot into Jack Pizda. Anyways, my main mission is not to hit Jack Pizda. My main mission is to hit the Fava. We are hitting Fava in the face, and from now on, we are going to go with the hits. Why? So, because it's just smart idea for us, right? And Jack Pizda superstructure, and now Jack Pizda is going to cry with the bloody tears. He can't do anything right here for us, and we can penetrate him pretty much wherever we want. This is the World of Tanks nowadays, fellas. You are loading heat and you are becoming stronger in a way, and the armor is getting kind of eliminated, if I can say so. By the way, that was a smart turn from my side. I was turning and moving back in the same time, so pretty much he simply had no chance to do anything for us. Anyways, we have a heat loaded, and I am thinking maybe Progetto is going to make some kind of mistake, but as you can see, it's not the case. Meanwhile, the 430U is going super aggressively for us, and I'm saying, Mother Trucker 1, come here, I'm waiting for you. I'm trying to hit him, and actually I had high explosive loaded. Sorry, my bad, I had high explosive loaded, I did not even notice it dead, but Fava managed to hit us in the face for a solid 1,100, and now it's looking like it's a game over. We don't have any support whatsoever, and Progetto is going super aggressively for us, but no, fellas, we are not giving up right here. Meanwhile, our clicker is helping us a bit with a Progetto, which is very, very nice. Progetto is down, and now we are going with a high explosives right here, and enemy Fava just took one for the team from our Fava for 900, which is excellent, and I reacted faster than this guy did. So what kind of options do I have? I can go for a Bobject, or I can go for extra shot on E100 and Super Conqueror. And obviously I am going for those two weed balls just because I can, right? And after that, we'll see. Bobject is going to be alive, or he's going to get tracked and farmed by the 430. Anyways, the first things first. I want to eliminate the Super Conqueror from the game. He reacted properly, but it doesn't matter because we managed to kill him in the side. And now I really want to get one more shot into E100, but I did not manage it to do that. So far, 7,000 damage, 1,000 assisting damage, and this battle was played perfectly in my opinion, apart one shot which I missed into the Jack Pizda over there, which was facing sideways. But in the end of the day, we farmed Jack Pizda anyway, so it doesn't really matter. So now situation, we are going quite aggressively against the 268 version 4, and why we are going to go aggressively, because this is only one way how we can get more use. Meanwhile, we rigged Brother in Arms, and Bobject is right here. I'm aiming for his cupola. Luckily, we managed to hit him, and he missed the shot for us. So what we are saying, Bobject, say my name, bitch. That's what we are saying. We are waiting until he's going down and until he is going to build a good angle for us. So easy, fellas, just like this. Bobject is moving aggressively, but it doesn't matter because I am hold down and he cannot penetrate us that easily, although probably he can overmatch our forehead, but it doesn't matter. He shot, I shot in the same time, so that basically means I have a faster reload, and we are pretty much just farming this beautiful pigeon right here. He's down to one shotable and he's dead. Beautiful battle. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful battle with a Bobject. In fact, fellas, that was the... Sorry, not with a Bobject, with a 260. In fact, that was so far the best battle with a 260 which I had in the RU server. And I am struggling with this tank quite a bit. I will play one or two live battles. Probably, let's make it maybe two. And after that, we'll see. So yeah, 260, the tank which a lot of people like, but I am not one of them. For some reason, I can't find the way how to make this tank working properly. I can't do anything about that. I'm trying, I'm learning, fellas. I am still learning. And hopefully we will get the third mark of excellence in first 300 games with this vehicle, and hopefully we will get up to 100% in 1000 games. This is my prediction. It's going to be very hard. Anyway, so far average performance 3.6 plus 800 for a comparison. The tank which is fitting with my style, for example, TVP 4.2 thousand 1.4, yep, this is the score with a TVP, or Progetto 4000 plus 1.4 thousand, or even Budget 3.6 thousand 1.5 thousand. You see, I am just simply not top class heavy player as I am with a medium tanks or with a light tanks. I think I am simply playing better with a different class tanks. Or maybe it is my fear speaking with me. Anyways, it doesn't matter. Stop cry, kid. You want to see the battle score. I know what you want to do, fellas. Soon we are going to show you this. So, battle score over there, my lovely friends. That was very first Ace Vanker, 9.1 thousand damage, 1.8 thousand assisting damage, 1.5 base experience. And that was epic battle. I am very happy, and I think I did everything properly in that game. Now, before everything, what we need to do, we need to change the server over there, fellas. So let's do this immediately, right? It's very, very important thing. Why so? Because in the Ru7, if I'm not mistaken, it's located somewhere in the deep Russia, so I would have a massive ping, and majority of the Russian servers are actually quite well playable for me. Anyways, stop complaining, skill, let's go into the battle. I will try to make this tank work in the live gameplay right now. Obviously, this is not pre-recorded footage, fellas, so let's expect for the best and let's hope for the best right there. So, the first things first. What do we want to do and what kind of options do we have? This is a tier 10 battle against the two Jeffs. By the way, matchmaking which I'm getting in the Ru server currently is pretty much majority of the times against the three artists, so this might be the reason why I am struggling with this vehicle so hard. At least that's what I think and that's what I guess. Anyways, what do we want to do right here? We want to make a hardcore pressure like this. I am not thinking about playing over there because this tank doesn't have the gun depression, and in the same time, as you can see, enemies have a chieftain, and if the chieftain is smart, there is a big chance he is going to bang us from over there, so I don't want to do that. Instead of doing this, I will take a typical position over there. I will try to stay hold down and I will wait until the E100 or Mr. Mouse either will try to cross or either will try to play on the corner over there. Now, alternative option could be, I could try to cross like this, and probably I would do that successfully, but I don't want to do this. Why so? Because then I would be stuck in the shithole, and I don't really want to be stuck over there, right? So we are in position, and all we need to do, we need to get a sip of coffee. Cheers. Beautiful coffin, nice. Okay, very, very good. Now patience. I know the Mr. Mouse and E100, they are probably over there now. They are very, very, very slow. They are going piri-piri in front and on super low speed, but in the same time, I can't do anything about that. Now this guy is getting banged just because of the position, of the decision which he made, and that was not so good, right? As you can see that yourself. And this Fava is currently waiting until we are going to peek, and obviously I did not want it to peek whatsoever. And the main reason why I did not want it to peek is extremely, extremely, extremely simple, because he have a high explosive gun. And what high explosive gun would do for us, a high explosive gun would do 700 damage either way. So right here we want to be smart. We don't want to do stupid mistakes. This guy is making a pressure. Good. He just got punished for roughly shit on of the hit points, which is good. And now what I want to do, I want to snap this guy over there. As you can see, fellas, yes, I'm shooting the hits, I'm shooting hits, but this is only one way how I can do the things properly in this matchup and in this situation. Because once again, playing hold down over there would not be the best option for us. So I want to play smarter idea. Okay, as you can see, the angle of E100 is very, very messed up. So I don't want to shoot him until I am going to have a nice angle like this. Beautiful. So heat is kind of necessary when you are fighting against the super heavies, my lovely friends. It's just how it goes, it's just how it is, and sometimes you need to do unpopular decisions. And I know a lot of people is against the heat ammunition overall or against APCRs, but it is the same thing like we would cry about the cars which is going outside, you know? I mean, we can't change it. We simply cannot change this kind of situation. It can be sad, and in the same time, if you are a principal in this kind of way, just simply don't shoot the heat yourself and shoot high explosives if you cannot penetrate, right? Anyways, so far, so good. This start is quite nice. I still have full hit points over there, and we are simply trying to bang this E100, which is playing around this area, right? And you know what? We are going to do everything properly. Russia, we are trying to hit his cheeks. Unfortunately, I did not manage it to do anything for him yet, but it's completely fine. Now pay attention what is happening. Our guys is making a hardcore pressure over there, so that basically means Chieftain will try to be quite aggressive over there, but you know what? His aggression is not going to save him whatsoever. The Chieftain is a dead meat. Anyways, meanwhile, Fava managed to hit me for like 400 in the face, but I don't really, actually 500 in the face, but I don't really care about that too much. And the E100 is sitting around this area. It doesn't matter because we are going to sidescrap against him. We are hitting him into the face right here, and I believe I should be able to reload before the Fava will, but I am kind of paranoid. Do I want to peek? I don't want to peek. I want to peek. I am peeking. Good. Although he managed to hit us once again. It doesn't matter because this game is about to be over anyways, and I am thinking how to eliminate this Chieftain from the game over there. So we are making a hardcore pressure in front, and obviously the Chieftain is going to take one into the side in approximately couple of seconds. Chieftain is taking one into the side, 3-1 now. Good. He took one for the team and he is dead. Now only two clickers is alive and Key 91. Fava is obviously waiting here on the corner, and I am kind of surprised and shocked why I took only 500 for in the face with a Fava over there, right, when he was hitting us directly. Either way, I'm not complaining. High explosives on, 261, and T92 is getting spotted right here. 3 seconds left, 2 seconds left, and kaboom, kaboom, double art or shot, it doesn't matter. Obviously, I did not manage to penetrate this guy with the high explosives, but oh, what can you do? That's life, right? And both of the clickers is trying to run for their life, but there is no escape, mother trucker. So in the end of the game, we managed to get 3,700 damage and 700 assisting damage, which, let's get real, it's not an good score for this tank. I need 5,000 combined as minimum. Maybe I should make a pressure a bit earlier. Maybe that was the thing which I needed to do. But oh well, no complaints, no regrets. Next, we are going for another battle right here, and maybe we are going to have tiny touch better score. Although looking into my average performance, that was an average game for me, and average is not good, unfortunately. Okay, what do we have here? We have the tier 10 matchmaking in the Pilsen, the top tier matchmaking in the Pilsen. So we are playing against the lower tiers. And now the question is, how the Flying F is supposed to get maximum use of all this? I have an idea. Very unpopular decision probably from my side. Look, with this vehicle, I need to play in a way safe, because armor is not that great as majority of the people is thinking of the 260, but you know what? I am going to try to risk it for the biscuit right here. And you might think, but Skill, what you are planning to do? I'm planning to go through the open field like this, and I'm planning to take this position over there. So all people which is thinking about gameplay over there, they are going to take one for the team. Plus on top of that, pay attention how many people we have over there which is going to snipe from the back. Which is not bad idea whatsoever from our side. I hope my risk it for the biscuit strategy is going to pay off right there. But once again, time is going to show everything. Meanwhile, Lynx is jumping like kangaroo. It's completely fine. 54 lightweight is thinking he is going to spot right there, but in reality he is pretty much going to get slaughtered. Progetto is sniping from the back, which is not a big of a deal for us, and we are simply going to eliminate this guy. Beautiful. Meanwhile, Lynx is still here, which is completely fine. We are making a hardcore pressure. We are not going to stop over there. Lynx is holy bananas. This guy is playing Need for Speed, not World of Tanks, but you know what? That will work. I'm not complaining too much. And now, what we want to do, we want to make a hardcore pressure like this. So maybe we are going to spot a Bushwankers which is playing around this area, and as you can see, it's definitely the case. Meanwhile, we are making even more a hardcore pressure right there in front, which is completely fine. Okay, I am not complaining. I am feeling very, very well. Meanwhile, Leopata is getting spotted, S1 is getting spotted. Holy bananas, look how many forces do they have. And once again, I am feeling quite well right here. This Progetto is not paying attention at the maximap. That's what we need, and we are going for half assisting damage right here. Meanwhile, this guy just jumped down, and it's completely fine. We managed to punish him in the ass, and he is simply peer trying to relocate right here. If you think I am feeling bad right here, you are absolutely wrong. I'm not feeling bad, because we are going to hit this guy now, and we are going in front. Why we are going in front? Because we want to spot the people which is playing over there, so we will get maximum use for ourselves, right? This is the main plan for us, and we are going like this. Meanwhile, Chimera is getting spotted, so Chimera should get effed by our guys which is playing in the back, right? And now we are going to craft even better angle for this poor cookie. Kaboom in the face, minus 500, and this is exactly what we need. Although I lost quite some hit points right there, which was completely unnecessary in my opinion. Meanwhile, the 430 is just simply going in front, and obviously he's penetrating me into the lower plate, because overall lower plate of this vehicle is relatively weak. Now this guy is probably thinking about eliminating me from the game, but it's not going to be that simple if I won't make a stupid mistake like I just did. Okay, so far so good. He just shot, and the standard B is here on the corner, but it doesn't matter. Now kaboom, another shot into the object, which is very, very good. And now I need to be a bit more cautious over there, but just tiny touch. Now I'm aiming for the cupola into the S5, and I in the same time I'm trying to escape a bit, right? I am trying to craft a bit better angle for this S5, which is very, very important thing. Another shot into cupola, go by a turret. Beautiful. We are bullying the lower tier in a way right here, but oh well, what can you do? Life is hard, fellas. Life is hard. So far, so good. Although we lost a lot of hit points over there, and speaking how many hit points we have overall, we have only 200 hit points, which is making us pretty much down to fartable. But we are not going to give up yet. We are not going to cry in the corner. We are going to try to be a bit smarter over there. I'm waiting till our standard B is going to peak, but probably it's not going to be the case. So what we are going to do, we are going to hit the enemy Arta, which is trying to run for his life. And beautiful, Arta is getting grilled. It smells like beautiful barbecue, fellas. Next, can we do some bad things for this standard B which is playing over there? The question is, from where he is going to peek? He's peeking from over there. Another shot into this guy, which is excellent. And now, as you can see, the Lynx is going for Need for Speed once again, and kaboom, Lynx is saying goodbye for his life. Beautiful. As you can see, this risk it for the biscuit strategy paid off right here in a way, and that went quite well in my opinion. How to deal with this 430? Any Benny Mikitaki, 430 is over there. I probably hit him, but what's from that? This Progetto is more likely sitting around this area, so this is pretty much game over for us, my lovely friends. At least that's what I think. Going for some blind shots, I'm trying to figure out where this 430 is hiding yet, but you know, if everything would be that easy. 430 is trying to run for his life, but we are saying there is no escape. And right here, my lovely friends, we are going to make a hardcore pressure just because I can. Kame, kaze, kaboom. We went for a ramming right here, we rammed him for 500 and we took, obviously, he took our life, but that was the maximum use as we could get. So we finished this battle with a solid 7,300 damage and 500 assisting damage, and I think this strategy which I had right here, it's paid off. But once again, only one Arta and tier 8 matchmaking. This is pretty much perfect matchmaking for this vehicle, right? And we managed to get 1.1 base experience, 7,300 damage, 700 assisting damage. Hip hip hooray, that was a good game. I'm very happy with it. And we did not need it to spam too much gold ammunition, right? Because we could penetrate everything without gold in this battle. So overall, after two battles, we have 5,500 damage and 700 assisting damage. But once again, I was quite lucky with matchmaking, and that was quite good play overall, right? So, my lovely friends, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one, and in the future you are going to see I believe couple of more videos with a 260, because I will try to storage those good games, and after that I will present them like 3x3 and so on. I'm speaking about those very good games, like we had the last one with a 9 grand, right? Anyways, thank you so much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill, and see you next time. Skill is out. Peace.